have you on the show.
Oh my gosh, thank you. You know, you called me the master of motivation, and I think motivation is complete garbage, so maybe we should start there.
That is a perfect place to start, so I totally agree with you. But
is motivation actually real, or is it just a myth we use to try to make us work?
There's a particular view and perspective that a lot of us hold that's very different. So today I actually wanted to touch on whether motivation in and of itself is significant, and if it's significant in creating change in the lives of people. The reason I actually am thinking about this particular topic this morning is because, well, I've listened to a lot of leaders in various fields. I will not say names this time around, but you'll hear them saying motivation is hogwash. Motivation is not necessary. Motivation, you know, is not key in people's success.
You know, if you study people who are at the pinnacle of anything, you recognize that to get there, motivation was maybe 1% of the formula. Maybe 1%. And I'll prove it to you.
And motivation is a waste of time. I hold a very, very different view. I hold a very, very different view. They'll say that largely the reason they feel those negative impacts around the subject of motivation is largely because, well, it all boils down to commitment, it all boils down to discipline, and it all boils down to action. That's when you are likely to see results.
I am one decision away from a totally different marriage, a totally different life, a totally different job, a totally different income, a totally different relationship with my kids.
But the truth of the matter is, what motivates you into getting to act? There's always a stimulus that is out there that will get you to act.
Not had an encouraging bloody word, a real encouraging word in their entire life. It just takes a little bit of encouragement and care so that they're willing to set themselves straight to some degree and start trying. It's just a catastrophe that's so rare in their lives.
There's always a stimulus out there that'll get you to be disciplined and committed. The stimulus may be wealth building and money. It may be significance in this world. It may be your wanting to contribute back to this world. It may be you're wanting to learn from others and then implement what you've learned, but by also building your capacity in the process. So motivation is a key component of you achieving all of those things.
I believe desire and will to win is everything. I don't know why I'm like I am, but my butt's always burning. There's always something to say, "Art, dadgummit, you're supposed to go for it. Art, dadgummit, you're supposed to be somebody. You're supposed to make a difference with your life."
Saying that motivation is not relevant is the same as saying that you never have a bad day in your life and everything will always be rosy. All you need is discipline, commitment, and action, and then you'll see results, right?
It takes courage to act.
If I want to be wealthy, and then I wake up every morning from a previously disenfranchised or disadvantaged environment. I wake up every morning and then I stand by the street corner waiting for someone who needs plumbing services to pass by and actually request my services, where I just have a board out there. And then on the contrary, there's someone who goes out there, is passionate about the plumbing business, goes out there, does a short course, you know, or a practical course on plumbing. Then immediately after that, while in the process of the short course, they are also learning how to market. They are also building networks with their peers, but also learning from companies that exist in the plumbing business and building their own business model around it. And then throughout that entire process, they are motivated to open their own business that pertains to plumbing. And then they hire people that have the plumbing expertise. They had a different motivation. So the guy that stood at the corner had the motivation to put bread on the table for example, and then they had the motivation to build a plumbing empire, right? The motivation is there in either circumstance, and that's just a simple example around it.
What does the $500,000 a year person do? The $50,000 a year person doesn't do. You look at the outside and study those two individuals, everything seems to be the same. They both are the same sex, they both are the same age, they have the same training, the same positions, the same contract, the same fringe benefits. They both are successful, they work hard, they're good family people, make tough commitments. But what's the difference? What does the $500,000 a year person do? The $50,000 a year person doesn't do. He pays the price and a little bit more. He works hard and a little bit more. He's loyal to the company a little bit more. He believes in a little bit more. He makes money a little bit more. He saves money a little bit more. If you want to win in these United States, you got to be tough and you can't quit.
If a person is fearful about opening their own business to begin with, yet they have the competencies, they have the skills, they have the ability, they know people in the industry, they even have mentors in that particular industry, they've read the books, and all they need to do is act upon it. Something that actually belittles their ability to act upon it would be fear in that particular instance. So wouldn't they then need a particular stimulus activator for them to actually overcome that fear?
That courage is going from failure to failure without losing enthusiasm. When you step into your fears and continue to push yourself to go on, something happens for you. It will enable you to transcend yourself.
More often than not, it's motivation. If they were to look at people who have opened businesses in similar spaces, and they follow those people and they go to the deep root of why those people were able to open those businesses at that point in time, one thing that they'll find out is that there was a particular thing that was pushing them to open that particular business. And that thing, my friend, is motivation. So once that person does that particular research on how did that individual overcome that fear, aren't they motivated to actually act now that they have all these expertise and competencies and have done the relevant research? I'd say yes, truly and for sure. They have that ability, so they will act. And that's all based off them having done the research and being motivated because they see that it is possible by seeing what other people are able to achieve.
If you can keep your head when all about you are losing theirs and blaming it on you, if you can trust yourself when all men doubt you, but make allowances for their doubting too, if you can wait and not be tired by waiting, or being lied about, don't deal in lies, or being hated, don't give way to hating.
If I am overweight as an individual, and the reason for me being overweight is because I've tried diet after diet. I love food, okay? I love to consume food, but I've tried diet after diet after diet, and it hasn't worked for me. That hasn't worked for me for a number of reasons, you know, if you were to think about it. It hasn't worked for me because, for one, the diet may have not been suitable for my blood type. Because these days, we need to be careful what types of food are suitable for our blood type if we have a particular goal for our physical health and prosperity, right? But at the same time, if I as an individual am not losing weight, not because of a non-specified diet regimen, but because I lack the motivation to wake up in the morning, and I suddenly say, okay, let me actually try and build habits around how am I going to do this.
People have an unbelievable capacity to face and overcome things they don't understand. And not only that, that's essentially what gives life its meaning. The Buddhists say life is suffering. And you think, well, if that's the case, why bother with it?
Well, now that we can see how short life really can be, what are you going to do with the rest of your life? That's a trigger. Huh? That's the biggest trigger that I have ever experienced.
And the first habit is to say, let me go to YouTube every morning and look at guys that are actually exercising and who have transformed their body in a particular period of time, and then do my best to follow their exercise regimen and their diet regimen and see what happens from there. If you watch those videos long enough, you watch those videos, you will be motivated and more so inspired to then act.
For gaining motivation, success. Specifically, the dopamine hit we get when we observe ourselves making progress. The main idea is that motivation doesn't lead to action. Instead, action leads to success, which leads to motivation, which prompts action, which generates more success and more motivation, and this creates a positive dopamine-driven feedback loop. It's these tiny doses of success that give us the motivation that we need to continue. And so with this model, motivation isn't based on like wishing and hoping that we're gonna get this activation energy to do the thing. Instead, it's based on this reality that we're creating for ourselves where we're doing the thing, we're getting small successes, we're generating those dopamine hits in our brain, and that is encouraging us to continue doing the thing.
So if you look at every key component, when I went to tertiary, I was motivated by the fact that I wanted to study environmental health. Why? Because there was that thing that, wow, in environmental health, I'll be able to assist people to not go to the doctor and not focus on curative health, but rather on preventive health. There was a motivation behind it. But more so, what was the distinguishing factor between me and my peers and university classmates at the time was that I entered and told myself, I'm gonna get a cum laude before I even knew what a cum laude is, you know? And I told the HOD after he enrolled me in and said, for enrolling me in, I promise you I'm going to get a distinction in every subject, in every module within this qualification of environmental health. That was what? A key motivating factor.
People don't value what they don't fight for.
Baby steps count too, as long as you're going forward. And one day you add all those baby steps up and you might be surprised at where you can get to.
I'm not saying that it ends at motivation, but I am saying let's not belittle it. Let's not just look at motivation in the sense of an individual who gets a speaking engagement as a motivational speaker.
It doesn't mean that I'm a bad speaker. It means that what I did didn't work tonight. And I've got to separate what I do from who I am. And I've got another shot. See, the last chapter to your life has not been written yet, and it doesn't matter about what happened yesterday. It doesn't matter about the things that you've done that you feel guilty about. If you wouldn't do it today, you're convicting an innocent person. You've been reborn to a new state of consciousness. And as they say, if we knew better, we would do better.
Who knows that largely a lot of individuals, after they walk out of there, they will most likely not follow the what that motivational speaker spoke about. But here's another paradigm that I'd like to shift. If two people within an audience of 40 are able to be motivated enough to overcome their fear, are able to be motivated enough to act upon the goal that they've been holding back upon just from that single engagement, and it just so happens that they had this brilliant business idea that they were afraid to act upon, and now that they've been motivated to do it, they actually start doing it, and you've given them creative tools on how to maintain that motivation, and they follow those particular steps.
I'm not asking that you believe anything that I say. I'm not asking that you agree with me. I'm merely asking that you stand on and in the conversation that we'll share with you this evening. And if there's something that I say that can fit and work for you, I say use it. If not, discard it and let it be. Is that all right?
Yeah.
Say, that's fair enough. Very good. All right.
Then this first step of motivation would have been the most significant one if they were to open a business that's scalable and hires 40 people in the process and actually becomes listed in the J-Exchange one day, right? It starts somewhere. So consider motivation not as something that when one speaks of it to you, you reckon it's something that is just going to transform your life. No. That's not what motivation is, and that's not what I feel motivation should be.
And if you're the type of person who thinks you don't have the willpower or determination like other people do, you're missing the essence of what a process is. People who have a strong process have found ways to make decisions that don't require willpower and determination. The trait that you really need for your process is grit, the ability to persevere and keep going even if you're scared, tired, or things are going wrong. Mental toughness is the foundation for long-term success.
Motivation is a fundamental building block to your destiny. You decide what that motivation is. Motivation is not hogwash.
Motivational speeches, talks, podcasts, YouTube videos, and more have helped me internalize the notion that motivation is what drives us to become the best version of ourselves. And this is what we need to become more like the successful.
Motivation is not unnecessary. Motivation is not a waste of time. Motivation is a key fundamental building block to your dreams, but it's something that you need to refuel and refuel. Hence, Zig Ziglar says that we recommend it each and every day. You need to be motivated each and every day, and you need to find those necessary tools. You know, open up a book that says Grow, Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill. You are motivated, number one, to buy the book. Then you are motivated to read the book. Then you are motivated to actually implement some of those strategies that will allow you to think and grow rich and implement the wealth. You know, get the wealth and accumulate the wealth, you know. So motivation is necessary. That is my perspective, my belief. And I think I've given a number of examples on this particular subject for you to be able to then think about it from a positive perspective, an optimistic perspective, a perspective that is likely to steer you in the direction of acting on those dreams that you have. So that wasn't a rant, though I think it may have sounded as if I was venting off and just going off at all the people that feel motivation is not necessary. I've said it before and I say it again, I myself am not a motivational speaker. But when something is necessary as a fundamental building block for us to achieve our dreams, I can't sit here and belittle it. I have to speak for it because it's a key fundamental building block for us achieving our dreams. So come on, as the youth, let's do it. Peace out.
There's something wrong, and human beings are allergic to the truth. Allergic. I will keep trying to speak my truth, but I know it's tough because a lot of these platforms are not built for truth. Like I said, they're marketing platforms. They're built so that I can generate as many views as possible, so that advertisers can say, hey, this Penuel guy has got 2,000 people that watched his video. Let's go advertise there so that more people can buy stuff and we can take their money. That's what it's built for. It's not built for sustainability. But we appreciate that a platform like YouTube for now is still highly, highly educational. And I'll carry on trying to respect the rules of these platforms so I can keep educating. Because if we don't, the world will implode.
Do me this kind favor, like, subscribe, share, press the notification bell if you feel there was value here for you. Cheers.